there are very, very small strains in it.
Yeah.
And this is the spirulina. This is this algae. It's not like a grass, and like a sea grass that some people think.
How do you keep it pure?
Yeah, we it has very high pH. It has pH between 10 and 11.
Okay.
And that's the best
help.
Yes, yeah. So this is like this strain. So when we start, we're like
one inside,
and then we put in some microelements, and then we pop it to you. That's all. Yes, and then it multiplies. And the only thing that it needs is water, sun, light, and warm. It has to be at least 30 degrees for the ideal circumstances, and CO2. And then it starts to doing photosynthesis. Yeah, and it multiplies. And then we harvest it. We harvest it out of this machine. Company, and this is like harvester, but it's still in the making. From the first, the main concept is like to put it across the sito, across the filter, through filter, and this is the 25 micron filter. And we put it between here, so this goes up, and then here goes the filter, then down, and it's pressed, and then we pump the spirulina from the pond in here, and in here these pedals are turning around and picking the spirulina that stays on the bottom and takes it out, and the rest of the water goes through and back to the pond. That's kind of the way that we harvest out spirulina, and then we press it with the press that also most of the water goes out, and then what remains is like really firm spirulina, like firm mass. It's like a very thick, I don't know how to say, maybe pudding, but very thick, very you can
pull
it up. Yes, but very, very strong. You can put it apart with a knife or with a spoon, and you can eat it like directly, or put it on some bread, or you can dry it. And then we dry it in down there. We have a drying machine. We do like a spaghetti on a plate, and then we put plates in a drying machine, and the air blows through, and it's dry. And then it's conservated.
So crunchy, so.
Yeah, this is the crunchy. We make spaghetti on a plate, and then when it dries, it's like a very firm.
Yeah.
And this is it. This
then,
is the crunchy.
Then you cut it also in
pieces. Yes. We just crush it a bit.
Yes.
Then we just crush it a bit, and they are this crunchy form.
And what do you do with the filter and the rest of it?
The rest of the water goes back to the pond.
Yeah, but the filter is for damage.
Which filter?
You throw it away.
You throw it away. The filter.
Or you can.
No. We reuse it. We don't harvest everything. We are just taking out a part.
Yeah.
Every day. That's when the summer. That's high season. We harvest every day, but every day just a little bit.
Yeah.
I don't know. Maybe one of a sixth. 1/6 of a spirulina that's in the pond, we take out, and the next
and
day
the
it grows
back.
And the water
but
goes
that's
back.
That's feeding for the next round.
Yes.
Is it because the high pH that it, not no other?
Yes, mostly because high pH, and also, but we are really making it high quality, and this what you can see above the panels is the spraying.
Yeah.
And then the water there is spraying every day, and it cleans under the paddle, so that spirulina doesn't stuck on the
paddles.
And then also at the edges of the pond, that's what spirulina is attached to. If you leave it a long time, and we clean this every week, and like this. And we also filter it, and we have like this anti-insect nets all around, and so it's really, really high quality.
But no problems with the bacteria, other algae?
Yes, no. For now, we didn't have any. We do regular testing, microbiology, and this in the laboratory here in Naklo. And yeah, for now it wasn't any problems.
And the water still has to run, movement.
What, the water,
the water has still to be...
Yes, it has to be moving because of it. The spirulina is like, as you saw, it's...
Algae?
Yeah, algae, yeah.
Yeah,
I can also show you how it looks like under the microscope.
Otherwise, it gets stuck to the sides, I think.
No, it gets it binds together. If I stop the pedals, the spirulina would I don't know, maybe
stick
in
together.
Few hours, yeah, stick together, and it would be like like balls, yeah, or like in the pond. And then some spirulina comes to the surface, it is on the surface together, some spirulina goes
to
the bottom, and then it makes shade. She is shading herself, and she doesn't. Spirulina that's outside has a lot of sunlight, but spirulina in of these balls doesn't have the sunlight, and then it doesn't grow optimally.
So it has to be spread.
Yes, that's why it's this pattern. So it's not mixing; it's still rotating, and spirulina goes up to the surface and down in the shade and up to the light and like this.
Yeah.
And then that's how it grows.
Yes, that's how it grows. Yeah.
How photosynthesis is it?
And they can find the
how much you can harvest.
Press?
Yes, this is some kind of a press. Yeah.
I have also I use food supplements.
Farmers in Slovenia, if they go to forest to hard work, they take this with
animals. We had cows for milk up here, Muslim, in here. In the then when we later will go in, that we then transfer it into like a small restaurant. And up here, my father and his brother started to process meat into dry meat products, and then they built also a shop. And then the shop, 3 years, was developing and changing a bit. And then right before the Corona, 2019, we moved it from there here and decorated like this. You can later have a look. So in here in the shop we sell our dry meat products that we produce from meat from local farms or also from two bigger cooperations. One is from Škofja Loka and one is from Kamnik that also has Slovenian meat. And then this, we mostly produce this and sell this here, and also our own potato. We grow maybe half a hectare of potato, normally Belarosa.
Pasora, that's meat.
Pasora, yeah, and also a bit of sora. And yeah, that's mostly it, and also some other things like the necessary things for living. And then in here, in this part, we have, like I said, small restaurant that's open only on agreements. Like today, that's what that a group of people comes and calls first and then orders what they want to eat, to drink, how they want to be served, and then we prepare this in our family circle. I'm Janez, and this is Simon, my father. He is the boss here.
that he understands.
So he has this. And also up here we have, in this building and up there we have apartments that we rent to people. And what's our farming thing is we have 10 hectares of land that on which we produce mostly corn. And then we sell it to other farms that has that have animals for animal feed. We also grow potatoes, as I said, and a bit of wheat for or barley for what was it?
For straw for malt.
For
crop rotation.
because of the crop rotation, sweetened barley.
And also we have around 20 hectares of forest, which we mostly use for building the roofs. You can see there are a lot of roofs. And up there you will also see the barns are all made of wood, and it's all from our forest. And we also keep all the buildings here and our house and this and the butchery on wooden chips. Wooden biomass. This and I also started 4 years ago with this spirulina that you tried.
Just a special information, we can discuss who is the boss, son or the father, because mother is not here.
Yeah. Only a dog has a boss.
Yeah, we can be loud now because the mother is not here.
Het volledige verslag van de reis van de aardappelkwekersverenigingen naar Slovenië is te lezen in het oktobernummer 2024 van Aardappelwereld. Het vakblad voor de aardappelsector. Bedankt voor het kijken.